Good morning. Here we are in the Cleveland National Forest, which actually is not near Cleveland, Ohio. This National Forest is in San Diego County, and it's February 11th, 2018. We are boondocking, actually dispersed camping here on the border of the Laguna Mountains Recreation Area. You're not allowed to disperse camp within the recreation area. And it's an interesting place. It was a lot of work finding this location. You have to have a permit. You have to be able to get through to someone in the office, the Forest Service office for the Descanso Ranger District. There are three ranger districts in this forest. And they gave us a suggestion of where we could go, and then we had to send them submit a permit and tell them how long we were going to be here. So we are only allowed to be here for so many nights, 14 days within a 30-day period. But in spite of all that, I really like it. I thought it was going to be so dry, scrubby, scrub brush. We're at 5,600 feet, and the pine trees are beautiful. We have this is our campsite here. And the problem is, we're kind of stuck right now, though. We thought we could get around that tree and this railing. We're going to have a little bit of work ahead of us trying to figure out how to get out of this tight spot we're in. More shots of our campsite. That tree is actually dormant, even though it looks dead. It might be an oak tree. And there's a hillside down below us. It's been really windy, but we've been lucky to be positioned where the hill is blocking a lot of the wind. So it was we had a nice evening, pretty good night's sleep. This is the first time we've been able to use a rock to level our trailer. Very convenient, although we are stuck here, kind of. The dispersed camping sites have really problematic access if you're towing a trailer like this one. I just think this would be beyond our abilities. We could probably do it with the 4Runner, that's for sure. But the trailer, I'm not so sure. Here's another example of why you should always walk the road before you pull your trailer down it. This little dirt road looks so tame at first. But then, still, if you stay to the left, maybe you could do it, if you're good at balancing. Hello, it's Sunday night and it's time for dinner. The sun has gone down. We had a great day hiking. It's supposed to maybe snow here. No, 10% chance. I wish it would snow. That would be really cool. Although I'm worried we might get stuck. I just want to show you just a couple little gear ideas. I'm sure everyone's maybe heard of these before. But I love the Dutch oven because it's really easy to clean with the Dutch oven liner paper. And we never have to really get it. You can never get the Dutch oven completely clean, in my opinion. It's impossible to get it completely clean. So it makes you feel like, hey, I don't have to really clean this very much. So that's great. Unfortunately, our water jug that we use when it's cold camping bit the dust, and we had to buy this thing. It's all right, but it's really hard to turn this. And so I'll put the link in the description. It's 5 gallons, but right now I'm not saying it's my favorite. Kind of has weak plastic. It's kind of
hanging over the, it's starting to hang like a bladder. Also, in the bed area, I thought I'd mention, over here, we've really enjoyed using this cargo netting across the back dormer. Those little lights are LED lights that save a lot of electricity. But the great thing is on the A-liner, you know, you can just put these little hook things wherever they're not going to interfere with the folding operation. And you can hang all kinds of stuff. I mean, I assume you could maybe put them, you know, you could put them here. Up and down here, and you can hang stuff here. So that's a good thing about the metal edging on the walls of the A-liner. Another thing we like to use are these little book lights. They just clamp onto the curtain, and at night if we're reading or watching a video, they just have some, you know, just low light and let us see where we're going, but they don't interfere with the movie, and one of us can try to go to sleep, the other one can keep reading, and they don't use any electricity. Another item that has just been fabulous, and I'm sure everybody's already using these, but I'll just mention it anyway, is the Corel dishware. I mean, you cannot break this. It's great, Corel. And tonight's special is chicken something, miscellaneous. Just Italian seasoning and salt and pepper and onion powder, and usually it tastes pretty good. The only thing about the Dutch oven that I'm not, you know, it's not quite as good as a grill. It's, things turn out a little bit soggy, but it's really a lot easier to clean, I think, than a grill. It's been raining all night. That's how loud the rain's been. That was a bad time to say that because it's not loud right now. Come on, rain. Rain and wind all night, and it's been really loud on this dormer here. A little condensation too. Actually, that's rainwater. Take it back. But we do have a lot of it's literally been raining and windy all night, and the weather report we got said 10% chance of rain and 0.04 inches of rain. Does that look like 0.04 inches? Not really. We did not make those tire tracks, by the way. Yes, we've changed campsites. It's Valentine's Day, February 14th, 2018. We unfortunately decided to leave the Cleveland National Forest. We thought about staying. I didn't show you the 2 hours we spent in the mud, cold, wet, wind, freezing, getting our trailer unstuck from the parking site that we were in, which was a lesson learned for us. We need to be much more respectful of the parking of our trailer, the way it's oriented, and our exit strategy. We just thought we could pull in there and make a, you know, we'd make it around the curve. We didn't really look. We're always kind of more focusing on how level the site is, and really we should be thinking about how we're going to get the trailer out of there. So we learned a lot from that experience. We were just covered with mud. The inside of the trailer was covered with mud. So we decided to head to the desert, because really the only time for me that I want to be in the desert is in the winter. It's just way too hot for me in the summer here. So here we are at Corn Springs Campground, which is a kind of out-of-the-way place. BLM campground near a place called Desert Center in California, and it is $6 a night. It even has the luxury of having some bathrooms, which we haven't been able to enjoy for a while. By luxury bathrooms, I mean a clean pit toilet. It used to be an old-time kind of oasis here, and it's very different. It's not maybe the most scenic desert place I've ever been to, but apparently people don't come here just for the scenery. They come here for the petroglyphs. So we're hoping we'll see some petroglyphs, and we've seen, you know, some wildlife. We've seen like a jackrabbit, some quail, and heard some owls. So far it's been nice, and the stargazing has been pretty good. Unfortunately today it's going to be cloudy all day, I think. And last night we were the only people here. It was really, really quiet. No one drove through. It's an 8-mile drive on rocky gravel road to get to this campground with lots of dust. The rocks looked really pretty sharp. Maybe you recall my other videos where we got 2 flats. Now we have our all-terrain tires. We aired them down to 35 about, so they still have air in them. I'm so happy this morning. Our trailer tires we didn't do anything with, and they seem to be just fine. Maybe we should have aired them down there, but the trailer doesn't weigh as much as the car, so. And we have a spare tire for the trailer. It wouldn't be quite as difficult to change a tire on the trailer. It was a great evening for sleeping here. The temperature was perfect for us because it was just the right coldness. It wasn't, you know, it wasn't super cold, and we were able to just, you know, we just closed the windows and didn't try to plug up any leaks, didn't turn on the Wave 3 heater, and it was really nice. A couple more lessons learned on this trip. Number one, don't store raw eggs in your refrigerator without putting them in a bag or some kind of container, because they will leak all over everything. We had them in the door here. This was not here. This was just a pile of raw eggs, goo all over the bottom and on the floor and all our food, and spent several, you know, about an hour cleaning it up. And in the process, of course, the refrigerator heated up, but we think the food's still okay to eat, we hope. Lesson number 2 or 12. When you're in the mud, a muddy situation, at least my thinking is, I'm going to take up these rugs. I'm not going to leave them on the ground. They got so caked with mud, and there's really no way to take that off on a trip unless you're outside beating them with a brush and water or something, which who wants to spend time doing that? But I don't think I would come here for the beauty of the flora and fauna. Those palm trees have definitely seen better days. I'm not sure if there was a fire here or if it's just been years of drought that have caused that. I guess the heyday of this oasis has passed, but this huge tree is really amazing. I'll have to look up the name of that. It might be ironwood, I'm not sure. There's some kind of underground spring here that has allowed this tree to grow to the size it's achieved. So I guess it's a good time for me to tell you about another huge lesson learned. And actually, we learned this on our trip to Arizona. I didn't want to make a video about it at the time because I was so upset about it. It was all my fault. The lesson was that we need to always have a checklist that we go down item by item before we start driving, pulling the trailer anywhere. Because what happened was I failed to remember to put the little clip that holds our wind assist pole onto the side of the trailer. Let me show you that. This pole at the top is our wind assist pole, and it connects down when the trailer's up. It connects right here with this pin. So when you put the trailer down, you swing the pole above the roof and over, and it connects up over here with the pin right here. I had the pin in my pocket and we had been driving for maybe 30 minutes and I felt my pocket and there was the pin. We pulled off the road and our wind assist pole was bent like this and it caused some minor damage to our trailer. So now we basically have managed to get it working again. I've got some new screws we put in there. We could hire a professional to look at it some more, but luckily it looked like it was pretty minor. The only thing is we now have a leak in the hinge right next to the door. Right now I'm not sure what's causing it, but water's getting in and leaking down the wall when it rains. Also, in that last incident, the latch here was pulled loose. These two screws were still intact, but these two were completely stripped and pulled out. And we had to go on the inside of the trailer and install ourselves on the trip a piece of metal, a plate, for this to grab onto. This is the plate we put in, and it seems to be working okay. We were lucky we could fix that on the trip. This is where the leak is, so we're still diagnosing how to fix that. This wash down below where we're camped is really pretty though, especially now that the sun's come out. The colors are incredible. I think I saw a fox slinking around down here. This is a gigantic bush right here. There it is. You know, we're not sure if some modern day human put that up there just kind of as a spoof. Now we think these look like petroglyphs, but can't tell if someone already went over them with their own scratchings or not. We found some more petroglyphs, we think. Here's another one. Looks like a real one. Now I call those cool petroglyphs. These guys went crazy with their petroglyphs. And there's even a historic marker. Then further west on the road out of the campsite is this abandoned mining place. Very funky. I think I'll go in and see what's in here. Someone's tried to preserve this. Oh, there's a display. Wow, what a collection of things. Here's the guest book. Interesting. Cool place.